Hello everybody, and welcome to a new episode of our Soviet 1968 campaign in Cold Waters. So, the moment of truth. Our submarine is damaged. We are quite low on weapons, although we still have a decent number of torpedoes and 7 of our anti-ship missiles. And I think we have just encountered the supply fleet that we are supposed to sink. Local conditions are favorable. It's raining. It's in the middle of the night. There's a very strong surface duct and a very strong thermal layer at 54 meters. That does certainly help us. So, without further ado, let's go in.
Товарищ командир, новый акустический контакт. Беллинг 301. Внимание в отсеках. Объявляется режим тишина.
However, this is not in our favor. The sea floor is not very deep. Only 130 meters. This is not a lot. Wait, where's that thermal layer? Wait a moment. This is not as advertised. There's no thermal layer. Damn. Okay. That's bad then. An abundance of targets. Already somebody is pinging. Come up to periscope then. I think I will need to use my periscope here. There's a lot going on. This is a lot of ships. I will concentrate on the cargo ships because they are my targets. They will be the ones. Oh, okay, this Garcia is quite close. 8.9 kilometers. Does the Garcia have anti-missile guns? Yes, and unfortunately does have anti-missile guns. Charles F. Adams. Okay, we are starting to pick up a lot of targets here. There we go, all tankers. Merchants. US cargo, US fleet, all tanker. US small cargo. 2 unidentified ships. A trawler in the middle of the fleet, that's not good. I would not like to hit you. Another US small cargo. Okay, how do we play this? We have 7 missiles and we have 4 targets that we need to hit. At least I think there are 4 targets. Bearing 319. Raise the ESM mast for a moment. Oh, very strong radar returns. Very strong radar returns here. Do I risk it? How close is this Garcia? 7.7 already. God damn it. Not good. Most certainly not good. I will have to employ quite a few tricks here. Okay, a new contact has been established. Airplanes. So they have airplanes too, huh? This Garcia is coming in fast. Can I get a position on Sierra 11, please? Before I start to fire away, I would really like to know what Sierra 11 is. contact is shaping up. My crew is doing a good job here. But yeah, we just have to wait a little bit. The damage to our submarine that has been inflicted in the last engagement, it's not substantial, but yeah, back here as well. It's not substantial, we do not have any flooding, but it's not, certainly not good. It's very bad, in fact. Okay, another military transport. That's what I thought. Okay, we have 5 targets. Can I change my torpedo loadout? Waycoming torpedoes all the way. Change those. And then I'll start to shoot. And I think I'll simply fire everything that I have. Let's come. Not so deep. 46 meters is a good spot. Let's come to that depth. Yep, I got an email. I always forget to turn off that stuff before I start to record. I hope you don't mind. No. Okay, here's the plan. I will start by firing my waycoming torpedoes. At this group, if possible. The cargoes might pick up a torpedo or two here. If they do, great. And then I'll finish off the rest with the missiles. 1, 2, 3, 4. I will still have one waycoming torpedo remaining for self-defense. That's good. That is needed. Or might be needed. I hope not, but yeah, you never know. This Garcia is getting awfully close. Oh, and he's listening. And I think he can locate me. In fact, I think they are all starting to turn away. So we need to start doing some things here. Let's wait for the last torpedo to be loaded. And then let's open up our barrage here. Now, I think one torpedo will be reserved for this Garcia. Yes, no, maybe. Actually, no. Okay, I will fire the torpedoes in a nice spread, ranging from here. Damn it, I didn't want to do that. There we go. Sierra 12 has been located. We have a submarine in the area. Let's fire this one. Like so. Start reloading the tubes. Okay, we have a Sierra 12. That will be a submarine. So that's why I'm very eager to reload these tubes right now. A nice spread of waycoming torpedoes has gone out. I do not yet know. Oh, okay. Torpedo spread is coming back our way. So let us, in fact, speed up a little bit here to get out of the way. Sierra 12 is still pinging. That's fine. We will have it identified in a moment. There we go. It's an Oberon. This thing is not a problem. This thing is garbage. I'm faster than these torpedoes, the Mark 20S. Yeah. Max depth 200, I can even dive under them. No problems there at all. So, the enemy ships are actually doing me a big favor right now. They are all turning away, including this Garcia. And that is something that I like very much, I can tell you. Because what that means... well, what I don't like is that these small cargoes might actually get outside of the range of our Wacom torpedoes. Oh, that's not good. They might simply get out of the range. Oh no. Okay, you know what? Let's use the confusion that we just created and prepare our missile salvo. 50 meters. I bet the Oberon is now very concerned with all these torpedoes coming close to it. He's actually starting to cavitate. However, so are we, but who cares. Here come our wake-homing torpedoes. Can I see them? Yeah, there's one passing. There's more. But they will not pick up the submarine. They are not designed for that. However, if I was the captain on that submarine, I would have a brown pants moment right about now. Okay. First order of the day, get rid of this Garcia. I need to slow down a little bit. Come on. Airplane nearby. Ah, the Garcia is still too close. I need to wait a little bit longer before I can start to engage. Yeah, okay, let's wait. Let's wait, then I will get rid of this Garcia. After that is gone, I will then fire the remaining missiles at the cargo ships. They will be completely at my mercy then. Okay, what is this Garcia doing? Oh, I hope I don't sink this trawler, but... oh, I think I might sink the trawler. Oh, that's unfortunate. Ah, accidents happen. You know, can't be helped. Oh yes, this trawler is in trouble. This cargo might still be caught by one of the torpedoes. Oh yes, I think it will. The other ones? Not so sure. I might wait a little bit, just lurk here, until... yeah, my torpedoes have just activated. Oh. I'm sorry. Didn't mean to. Ouch. Well... what can you say? It happens. This cargo ship certainly has a bunch of torpedoes going for it. So I think I'll just count this out as sunk. Yeah, pretty much. Torpedoes are going for it. These two have turned for the trawler, unfortunately. They've picked up the wake of the trawler. The trawler in the middle of their formation... that's unfortunate. That's very unfortunate. Oh, and he has more torpedoes detonating against his hull. Oh, poor guy. Poor, poor guy. Okay. Let's observe. Oh, I lost a torpedo. But yeah, this cargo... I don't think he's getting away. He will eat a torpedo. In that case, we should start to blast away. Oh yeah, there we go. Cargo has been sunk. Now, why do I want to sink this Garcia? Well, you see, this Garcia has anti-missile guns. And it might intercept missiles that I fire at the cargo ships, so I will take it out first. That way, he's gone as an obstacle for my missiles. Now let's fire just like so. Missile away. Missile away. Missile away. Missile away. That's a bunch of missiles. Let's actually watch this. He's trying to evade, and I think he did it. I think he has successfully evaded the missile. Oh, wait, no, he hasn't. He's gone. And now for the fleet here. Watch this. Oh, one missile has been intercepted. There goes one ship. There goes another ship. Oh, two missiles have actually been intercepted. Isn't it great that we still have two missiles remaining? Yeah, so we will just come up again. And fire off our last two remaining missiles at this US small cargo. He was the one with the anti-missile guns. And at the military transport. I did lose the contact of the US small cargo here, but I should regain it momentarily. Yeah, I have it back. Now I just need the exact position again. Last missiles are standing by. The Charles F. Adams here has turned around. However, I don't plan to be anywhere near him once he reaches this area. Now I need the position of this small cargo, please. Come on, crew. Hurry up. Do your job. Anti-missile guns. Oh, you little... It's fine. It's perfectly fine. Actually, there's an airplane, so it's not perfectly fine. He knows approximately where I am. I can't get a good position on the small cargo. Come on. It's nowhere near up there, it's somewhere down here. Okay. Solution is shaping up very slowly, but steadily. So, we could use the periscope, but I doubt that we'll be able to see it, in all honesty. We can try. Your small cargo, bearing 342. No, it's lost in the haze. Or is it? What is that? That is the military transport. That is... I don't know what you are. Where's the small cargo? Okay, I have it. lower the periscope. Does the Charles F. Adams have anti-missile guns? Yes, he does. Damn it. He's close to the military transport now. Oh well, can't be helped. Fire. And let's fire like this, maybe. Now let's get out of here. We are done. What happens, happens now. Let's watch. Oh, he's turning. He knows what's coming. He saw the launches. He knows what's coming for him. Ah, lost him. Oh. Oh no, yeah, I forgot for a moment that the floor is not very deep here. Don't run into the ground. There we go. Small cargo has been sunk. That's good. Well, only the military transport is remaining. I mean, if there's one target remaining in the end, that doesn't matter. I think we should still be okay. Yeah, I don't think we have sunk the military transport. Doesn't matter though, now our task is to get out of this area. We will use a trick for that. Let's slow down for a moment. And we will fire a decoy right into the path of the enemies. While we continue to run away in the other direction. Okay, let's go. Charles F. Adams has actually turned around. And now we'll use some time compression to get out of the area for good. And I think we should be able to do that. The Charles F. Adams has actually turned around. I guess he's protecting the military cargo. So now we just have to get a little bit away from here, while our decoy will completely confuse the hell out of them. If they go after anything, it will be after the decoy. And we should be able to just get out of the area. Let's see, weapons and vessels nearby. That's fine, let's just continue. We are doing well here. And we are getting out of the immediate area, that's good. Now, the enemy submarine might be able to hear me, so that could be an issue. It might not be going for the countermeasure. However, yeah, still vessels nearby, so we are still too close, probably to the submarine. Just have to wait for a little bit longer, and then we can leave the area. And that should be a successful mission. And we need successful missions right now, you know that. Still vessel nearby, okay. Let's see, the distance to the Oberon should be about... Oh well, we should be almost out of its area. There we go. Leaf combat. So, we have sunk one Garcia, we have sunk one US cargo ship, one US fleet oil tanker, two US small cargo ships. A military transport has escaped. We also sunk a neutral. I hope that won't be held against us at some point. For now, congratulations on a job well done. The loss of these supplies will greatly harm the enemy. Await additional orders on this downlink. I hope my new orders are get back to Murmansk. Ships turned and fled. A spokesman for the Soviet Navy today revealed that enemy supply convoys were successfully repelled by the naval blockade of the British southwest of the United Kingdom. A large convoy of enemy ships was aggressively engaged, numerous ships were sunk, and vessels that were still afloat quickly turned around and left. All true. The success of the recent Soviet Navy continues to have a significant and lasting impact on ground warfare. Initial suggestions that the role of the Navy in this conflict would be limited at best proved incorrect. And here we have our new mission. Immediately return to Murmansk. Thank God. Repairs and replenishment. That's what we'll do. Let's continue on course. Oh no. No, 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 no. No, don't do that. Let's save. This is not good. Oh shit. Okay. This is really not good. Really, really, really not good. We have a new sonar contact, bearing 321, designated Sierra 1. What will we do about that? Will we survive another encounter with our by now extremely limited choice of weapons? 4 SET-65 torpedoes and 1 precious Wacoming torpedo is all that we have left. Really not good. Now, to find out if we are surviving this or not, tune in next week and let's just hope together that this works. Until then, I hope you enjoyed the episode. Goodbye.